React is a Frankenstein. Angular is too complex, and nobody uses Vue. So I've created a new and better JavaScript framework. Relax, I'm just joking. Let's talk about which JavaScript framework you should learn. First off, if you're working for a company or you're trying to join one, learn whatever they're using. Now, if they're using something outdated, like jQuery or AngularJS, also known as Angular 1, then in this case, you need to learn what they use and also learn a new, modern one to switch to later. Do not annoy your team members talking about switching frameworks before doing your research and listing all the benefits. Switching frameworks is a huge effort, and chances are that they are already very proficient in the current framework and don't want to lose all that knowledge. If you do have the power to decide any framework, my advice to you is stick to the framework Trinity. Svelte is cool, Elm even more, and Polymer is a candy. But you will have a really hard time finding jobs that use them. Leave those for your weekend hackathons and stick to Angular, React, and Vue for the big projects. Angular really thrives with complexity. It has what you need, what you don't know that you need, and what you really don't need. All out of the box. The learning curve is indeed steep, but I think it's totally worth it because it will save you many headaches in the future. It comes with dependency injection, internationalization, forms handling, scoped styles, server-side rendering, routing, lazy loading, animations, a CLI, style guide, coverage reports, setup for unit and integration tests, an HTTP client, and conversion to native custom elements. If you need more, there's even a component development kit. It is huge. React alone is just a rendering library, but when you use it with Create React App, Gatsby, or Next.js, you get a full framework. Everything that doesn't come with it, you can add later. Server-side rendering with Gatsby or Next.js, scoped styles with styled components, HTTP client with Apollo, routing with React Router, state management with Redux, and so on. The upside is that it's more customizable than Angular, but that can also be considered a downside, because any new devs will need to study not only React, but also all the tools that you choose to use with React. Vue is a great middle ground between React and Angular. It's less complex than Angular and more complete than React. It has a CLI, a fast learning curve, and you can add more things later, like server-side rendering with Nuxt, router with Vue Router, forms validation with Vue Validate, state management with Vuex, and so on. Another huge difference from the other two is that we don't have a huge company sponsoring Vue. It was created by a single developer, and it's maintained by the open source community. They have explicitly declared that their priority is to ship quality code that is ready for production rather than hitting specific deadlines. It all seems great, right? But Vue is the least used in production of the three. It's very popular in the East, but not as much in Western countries. Many libraries are written in Chinese, which might be a problem if you don't know the language. For full disclosure, I prefer and am most proficient with Angular. I love TypeScript, I love having everything out of the box, and most of my clients use Angular. That said, I wish it was less object-oriented and more functional, like React with hooks and functional components. Please, leave a comment if I've missed anything. Making a good decision is more important than me being right. So, if you have something to contribute, please leave your opinion in the comments. I hope this was helpful. Have a great day, and I'll see you soon.